Good morning. I'm Alessandra Manzin from the Italian Meteorological Institute in Torino. The work I will present deals with the modeling of mononic crystals based on permalloy antidote arrays for possible application in the detection of magnetic nanoparticles and in the future integration in lab on a chip systems. The aim is the study of a novel sensor concept that exploits ferromagnetic resonance phenomena in nanostructured magnetic films, like antidote arrays. The sensing mechanism is based on the generation of detectable shifts in the ferromagnetic resonance frequencies or in the ferromagnetic resonance fields of the high frequency spectra of the nanostructured films. These are caused by the interaction between the stray field produced by the magnetic particles and the magnetization configuration in the films themselves. The idea of exploiting magnetic antidote arrays derives from the possibility of using them not only as high-frequency magnetic sensors with properties tunable by varying lattice geometry, but also as traps for magnetic particles and beads. In this framework, we investigate the mechanism of particle trapping by calculating the magnetic force produced by the antidote array on the particles themselves. Then, we analyze the ferromagnetic resonance-based sensing by varying the particle properties and the antidote array lattice geometry. Finally, we compare this novel mechanism of detection with anisotropic magnetoresistance-based sensing. The modeling analysis is performed by using a parallelized micromagnetic solver that was developed to efficiently solve the Landau-Lischitz-Gilbert equation in large patterned films. Specifically, the demagnetizing field is calculated by using a fast multiple method for the evaluation of the long-range contributions. The exchange field is computed with a finite difference method which is able to handle unstructured meshes. Details of the micromagnetic solver can be found in the references below. In the parametric analysis, the magnetic antidote arrays are permalloy films with hexagonal lattice and holes with a diameter variable between 200 and 400 nanometer. Two types of magnetic particles are considered to study the mechanism of detection. They are commercial magnetic beads, which can be employed in biosensing and bioseparation. The DynaBead has a size around 1 micrometer, while the MagSignal has a size of about 300 nanometer. The fittings of their magnetization cars are reported in the top right of the slide. For a bias field of 150 kA per meter, which will be considered in the ferromagnetic resonance spectra analysis, the magnetic moment of the DynaBead is more than one order of magnitude larger than the magnetic moment of MagSignal. To analyze the trapping mechanism of the antidote array, first we calculate the magnetic force that the antidote array produces on the beads, after having calculated the stray field from the antidote array itself. Then we analyze the sensing mechanism by calculating the ferromagnetic resonance spectra, comparing the cases with and without beads absorbed on the surface of the antidote array film. The comparison is made in terms of ferromagnetic resonance frequencies and spin wave mode profiles. The analysis is performed by setting the bias field along the y-axis, which corresponds to the hard axis for the lattice of the considered antidote arrays, while the ferromagnetic resonance behavior is produced by applying a uniform excitation, and in particular a Gaussian pulse along the x-axis, which corresponds to the easy axis for the considered antidote arrays. The analysis of bitwrapping has demonstrated that the holes in the antidote array behave as absorption sites for bits at large applied magnetic fields. This is visible in the maps of the magnetic force produced by the antidote array on the particles. Specifically, large attractive forces, which correspond to the negative peaks colored in blue in the maps, are found above the antidote array holes as a consequence of the interaction with the magnetostatic field produced by the antidote array. The force amplitude decreases when reducing the external magnetic field. The analysis of the mechanism of sensing puts in evidence that the presence of magnetic particles trapped at the antidote array holes leads to a perturbation of the ferromagnetic resonance spectra of the antidote array, with a shift in the frequencies of the main ferromagnetic resonance modes, which depends on the size and magnetic moment of the bits. The main ferromagnetic resonance modes are the edge 1 in correspondence to the whole edges, the quasi-uniform modes extended over the whole lattice with stripes perpendicular to the bias field direction, and the localized mode, which appears in between neighboring holes. The sign of the shifts in the ferromagnetic resonance modes depend on the type of bead. This can be explained by considering that the ferromagnetic resonance frequency increases if the stray field of the bead, when interacting with the magnetization spatial distribution in the antidote array, leads to an increase in the effective field in the antidote array itself. In particular, for the smaller bead, which has a size comparable to the one of the hole, the stray field opposes to the demagnetizing field of the antidote array for the edge and quasi-uniform modes, thus leading to an increase in the relative ferromagnetic resonance frequencies. For the localized mode, it opposes to the bias field and thus a reduction in the relative ferromagnetic resonance frequency is obtained. For the larger bead, the stray field opposes to the bias field for all modes, thus leading to a decrease in the ferromagnetic resonance frequencies for all modes. The mechanism of detection can be optimized depending on the size of the antidote array holes. In particular, the amplitude of the frequency shifts is larger when the bead has a size similar to the diameter of the holes, because in this case the coupling between the antidote array and the bead is better. Regarding the role of hole filling, it is worth noting that random distribution of bits impacts in a weak way on the ferromagnetic resonance frequency shifts. But in the presence of a bead stratification over the film surface, there is a reduction in the detected signal due to the magnetostatic interactions between the beads. Finally, we have investigated if the antidote arrays can also be used as anisotropic magnetoresistance sensing elements. To this aim, we focus the attention on permalloy antidote arrays with rhombic lattice. In the presence of beads like the ones considered in the previous analysis, there are negligible variations in the anisotropic magnetoresistance response, since these beads have a practically null magnetization at remanence. The detection of beads with large coercive fields, like the ones made of neodymium iron borum, is possible and manifests itself with a shift in the antidote array switching field. In conclusion, the analysis has demonstrated that magnetic antidote arrays can be used as traps for magnetic beads or sensors for bead detection based on ferromagnetic resonance or anisotropic magnetic resonance phenomena. The ferromagnetic resonance sensors exploit the ferromagnetic resonance frequency shifts in the gigahertz range. The study has shown that the shift sign is a function of bead size and hole diameter, and the shift amplitude is maximized when the bead size is comparable to the hole diameter. Moreover, the detection is strongly affected by lattice defects, such as variations in hole diameter. The anisotropic magnetoresistance sensors exploit the shift in the switching field of the antidote array. This mechanism of detection is possible only for bits with large coercive fields. I would like to thank you very much for the attention. See you at the MAG conference.